mansion of madness. For some, it's a work of art. For others, it's their worst nightmare. With some of the most colors, obstacles, moving parts, and inconsistencies of any other custom track, this one is prone to drive beginners insane. That is why today we are going to visit the home of the corrupted Wiggler himself to teach you Mansion of Madness. Let's get started. The first thing you want to do is to delay your wheelie upon getting your startup boost, as the straight is just a bit too long for one wheelie. As you approach the first ramp, trick off of it and land in a tail dive. It does not matter which side you take here, both are identical. It all depends on what item box you are going for. As you land, wheelie up the black slope, then hop towards the wall to realign. This next trick can be inconsistent for some. To get this consistently, cancel your wheelie right before reaching the ramp, then do an up trick. Next, trick off the ramp ahead, and if you took the left path, hold right to align towards the center of the road, then land in a tail dive and wheelie. As you land from the ramp, there are two crabs that move from side to side in this pattern as shown. However, these crabs are not much of a problem, as you have some time to avoid them once you land from the ramp above. Next, trick off the ramp in between the stereos and nosedive. You can also trick to the left of the stereos, however this does not save much time and is not mandatory. As you land, start a left drift to follow the curve, then wheelie towards the boost panel. Next, there are a series of boost panels with a spike wall on both sides. These walls move in and out with a pause in between. Hitting these spikes will cause you to spin out, even at a low speed. Keep in mind that when the spikes are out, they almost completely block access to the boost panels. The fastest way to do this section is to align towards the center of the road, and do an 08 drift to the left to hit the first boost panel on the left side. Then, holding right to hit the second boost panel on the right side, followed by hitting the left side of the next two boost panels to avoid the spikes. This, however, is not the method that should be done every time. When the spikes are up, it is very difficult to get all the boost panels, especially the first one on the left as it is completely blind. Getting one or two boost panels out of the four is much better than trying to get all of them and spinning out because of it. After the boost panel section, start a right drift and get a mini turbo. Then release for the left side of the boost ramp in the distance. Do a drift trick to the left off this boost panel, then hop onto the next ramp and trick. You can also do a drift trick to the right off the second ramp for decreased airtime. On lap 2, the floor falls and you will have to go to either side to avoid falling off. As you land from the second ramp, do a wide left drift along the edge of the road. Then, as you get your mini turbo, release and wheelie with a right follow through. Proceed by doing a delayed left drift and once again drift wide to avoid falling off, then release for the wavy section ahead. Drive along the wavy section and wheelie along the downward slopes. Do not try to drift on this wavy section, you will fall off. After the wavy section, trick off the ramp and drive along the moving colored road. There you will see the Wiggler, which is not a problem as you have a lot of time to move around it. After you pass the Wiggler, hit the boost panel in the center of the road, then the boost panel on either the left or right side, as the gray road is off-road. This next straightaway is one of the dumbest things in any CTGP custom track. with bullet bills being shot at you from both sides and a large bullet William getting shot down the center, which almost completely covers the entire path. So, how do you avoid all of this? Starting with the large bullet bill, you can avoid this by going to the very left or right side to stay on the boost panel road. This is quite difficult to do, so you can also just drive off and bounce back on. For the small bullets, there is a cycle to them. Most of the time, you can just wheelie down the road without any problem. You will get caught in what I call the cycle, when you are just behind the first bullet when you get on the boost panel, as the bills will get progressively closer to you until you get hit. If this happens, you can attempt to avoid them by swerving to the left and right, though it's better to just drive off to the side if you notice that you are in the cycle. If worst comes to worst, you can also just hit a bullet bill and continue forwards. This doesn't actually lose all that much time. Also, do not drive off close to the end of the boost panel road, as you will actually get stuck against the wall, losing a monumental amount of time. After this bullet bill section is probably the most hated part of the track, this zipper. Everyone at one point in their time has gotten rejected by the zipper, losing seconds of time. Getting rejected by this is honestly one of the most frustrating things in the game. So how do you get it consistently? The three main reasons as to why you would get rejected are because you went below the wall, you tricked too late, or you are in a wheelie in midair. Due to the trick and wheelie inputs being the same, when you uptrick off the zipper, you can get a wheelie as well, causing you to get rejected. So, to get the stick, you want to get a down trick, and you want to trick a good amount before the end of the wall. This will ensure that you will not be in a wheelie, allowing you to stick to the wall. Now, there will still always be that risk of getting rejected if you do this incorrectly, so a backup strat is to avoid the zipper and trick off the road here. Along this straight, you can see that parts of the floor fall down. The most notable one is the one right at the start of the straightaway that falls at around 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So at a slow pace, this can be a problem. If you know that the floor has fallen, be sure to trick off the zipper a bit later, as if you trick off early as normal, you will not go past the fallen floor and you will get counted out of bounds. Also, the backup strat that I mentioned, you can still do this when the floor is down, as you can trick over it. So this backup strat is risk-free. After getting the stick on the zipper or after doing the backup strat, align flat along the zipper and tap right to get multiple boosts. Then, trick off the side of the zipper and land on the road below. You can also trick off the actual ramp to get an item box if needed. Upon landing, align towards the yellow panel ahead and wheelie. Then as you hit the black boost panel, start a right drift and drift down the slope. Proceed by drifting right off the first three ramps and releasing your mini turbo in midair to get more distance. Wheelie along the fourth section and wheelie off the fourth ramp. Then drive along the fifth section as normal and hold left off the fifth ramp if needed to avoid falling off. Drive along the sixth section on the right side, then wheelie off the sixth and final ramp. For this entire boost section, be sure to not be too risky. The worst thing you can do is try to cut off too much and failing because of it. If you are most comfortable with cutting off less, then do so. After landing on the large boost ramp, drive up it then start a left or right drift and hard drift as you reach the top to get a mini turbo. The final section of the map has thwomps that move left to right. As you can see, there are two pairs of three thwomps and one lone thwomp sitting in between. As I mentioned, the thwomps move left to right, with the single thwomp going through the wall and the three thwomps stopping just before the wall. It is really important to avoid these thwomps, as if you hit one, you can lose a few seconds, which can end up losing you a lot of spots at the end of a race. To avoid these, I like to hold my mini turbo longer until I make a decision of where to go. Finally, as you pass the thwomps, trick off the final ramp to finish the lap. Be sure to re-hop before your boost runs out to prevent having to chain your wheelie. Mansion of Madness has three shroom shortcuts, but to be honest, they are all kind of useless and give extra risk of getting target shocked. The first shortcut is right at the start where you can shroom and trick off this ramp to enter this hidden area. This shortcut saves nothing. I've never really done it before and you are better off just shrooming through the sides. The second shortcut can only be done on lap 2 by shrooming through the snow and doing a wheelie off the ramp. I will give this shortcut a little bit of credit as it saves the most time of all the shortcuts on this course. However, not only does it skip over an item box, but if you get target shocked in the snow, you lose many seconds of time. This added on by the fact that the shock is very common during this part of the map makes this shortcut high risk and low reward. The third and final shortcut is done by driving off the right side of the fifth ramp and holding back in midair to land on the transparent prism. Proceed by shrooming as you reach the prism and doing a wheelie off of it to the boost ramp below. Although it may look like it, this shortcut saves very little and can be quite difficult with one mushroom. This added with once again the chance to do getting TS to make this shortcut, like the rest, not really worth going for. As I mentioned, the shortcuts on this course are very low in viability, so this course is definitely one you want to play from the front. Mansion of Madness is also a course that you want to play very conservatively. Getting rejected by the zipper or falling off the track can leave you in the back with no chance of catching up. Do what you are consistent at and you will see better results. This track is played basically every CT Lounge event and the shock is used basically at the same spot every time, at the start of lap 2. This is the section of the map with the least amount of boost panels as well as there being a snow shortcut, so people love using the shock there. Another thing to mention is that in low tier rooms, there are usually multiple people that struggle a lot, so the shock will most likely be used much earlier. Lastly, when in the front, there are a few spots where you can back items to get a bigger lead. Those include putting items on the spike section, as it will make players unable to hit some of the boost panels, and putting items on the ends of the boost ramps at the end of the course, as well as right when you land from the boost ramps, as these are very unpredictable and can cause someone to fall off if they hit one. And that is all for this one. This track will always be insane, unpredictable, and triggering. There was a lot to cover here with all the obstacles, so I hope you learned a thing or two without feeling too overwhelmed. But with that said, if you enjoyed, be sure to like and subscribe. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all next time.